We have learned that non-economic factors are as important as economic policy. And economic policy is very important. We need to keep it. And that is not going to be easy in Latin America. There are countries that are growing well, but that are going to have trouble. Argentina, Venezuela, to talk only about two, that have been growing well, but will have significant trouble because some mistakes, big mistakes of economic policy. But there are some non-economic aspects that are important. Social peace, good relations between political parties and members of society are important. What is happening in Bolivia is very threatening and very dangerous. What happens in Venezuela is bad for that society. That polarization is bad for that society. The political stability. Political stability is very important. I mean, we cannot dismiss that. And one of the things we learned through this process is not only economic policy counts. That was the idea in Latin America during the all post-war period, and it was the idea after globalization came. The only thing that is important is economic policy. That is wrong, totally wrong. Even if you only think in non-economic factors, you start to think that that is a wrong approach to problems. Political stability. Ecuador has had terrible problems of political stability. President Correa is from the left. I think he's making some mistakes also, but he has brought political stability to that country, and that is important. The lack of political stability can be very damaging to an economy. We remember the problems in Central America and the lack of growth and all the balance problems because of lack of political stability. The respect for the rule of law. Latin American states have been very arbitrary many times. Officials are arbitrary, very arbitrary. Many investors don't feel comfortable in Latin countries because they don't find respect for the rule of law. They don't find a judiciary that really helps to respect the rule of law. And that is something that we are learning the hard way, but we are learning that non-economic factors, this type of non-economic factors, the respect for foreign investments, it's critical and it's important in a world that is as is today with globalization. Those things become really critical, really critical. An investor that sees that there is no respect for the rule of law, no matter how much is the return, will not invest, will not do it. And Latin America, that had a tradition of anti-foreign investment, has learned that has to change the attitude. And I hope we are learning. In most countries, we are learning. In some, we are not. We are still seeing some countries some arbitrary decisions. And in this period in which we are going to enter, of financial problems, of lack of confidence, those problems are going to become bigger for the countries that are not working in these matters. How we are going to face this period of financial crisis is difficult to know. I mean, nobody knows in the U.S. how painful this is going to be. Nobody knows. I mean, we know it's going to be painful. We know there will be some recession for a period we still don't know. I hope it will not be more than three or four trimesters or two. The U.S. economy was doing very well. Even with all the trouble, the second trimester of this year was 3.3 of growth. While the European economy was sinking, and the Japanese, the U.S. economy, with all the problems with the mortgages, with all the problems of the financial system, before the crisis of the last 2 weeks, was doing much better. And I hope the dynamism of this economy will be able to bring this country back to growth quite soon, and that this will not be a long recession. But of course, I'm not certain of that. Most people think a different way. Most people think that probably is going to be a big recession. The things that are happening every day are very scary. I mean, every day the news are more surprising and brings very... European financial system is having today as much trouble as the U.S. And that had been a matter of a week. In a week, very big financial institutions in Europe are banging down. They are taking decisions a lot more troubling than the 700 billion decision of the US Congress. Germany yesterday decided that they were going to support all the accounts of all the banks in Germany. I mean, that is going a lot farther than what the US is doing. So that just shows how serious the problem is. I hope it will be possible to keep confidence in the payment systems, because the banking system is that, it's the payment systems. If that comes down, the economy paralyzes. We can have no doubt on that. The measures that are being taken in Washington, no matter how painful they are, they have to be taken, because otherwise it's going to be risky. Of course, there has been corruption. Of course, there has been incompetence. Of course, there has been greed. At some moment, the U.S. have to sanction that. But right now, let's keep in. I think the U.S. in this year, this precise situation, had a good team. I cannot say the same from some other of the secretaries of the Treasury of the Bush administration that did make mistakes. But at this moment, at least I think they had some competent people doing their job. We have developed better institutions in Latin America. Until now, there has been, as a consequence of the last year of crisis, the mortgages crisis, the Latin America has been doing quite well. I mean, has been doing quite well. No financial institution in Latin America until today has been in trouble. So we learned the hard way, and I hope that it will be possible to keep Latin America growing, even with the recession in the U.S. and Europe. But anyhow, after so many painful years and a short period of growth, or 4, 5, or 6 years, to have again a crisis, or a financial crisis as the one we left behind, it's going to be very painful for us. Now, what else we have to face? The social challenges. I mean, Latin America is the most unequal region in the whole world. More unequal than Africa, more unequal than Asia. It's the most unequal region. And we have levels of poverty that are totally unjustified. Totally unjustified. And I say it because when you see the problems of poverty in Mexico and the strengths of the Mexican economy, you see that we are making many mistakes in Latin America. We are still making many mistakes. The quality of our social policies is still not good. The World Bank, some years ago, 5 years ago probably, tried to understand why Latin America, how was education in Latin America in comparison with the tigers of Asia? Tigers are the countries that grow well in Asia, there are many. And they discovered that with the same amount of the national product, the Asians had 3 or 4 more years of education and had much better education.